Xenia is the absolute best Xbox 360 emulator for PC, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to install it and give you a general walkthrough on its features so you can play your games with the best settings. The emulator official website is this one right here, xenia.jp. I'll put the link of this one on the description of the video, and we're gonna start by clicking here on the quick start guide of the emulator. And right at the beginning, you're gonna see the system requires to run this emulator on your PC. Both the recommended and the minimal specs are listed here. If you played games on your PC before, you most likely already have Visual C++ installed on your computer. But if you're not sure, you can run the setup anyway. So just click here to download it and install it. Scrolling down on this page, you're gonna see the links for both the Master and the Canary builds of Xenia. Master is the build of Xenia that has the latest stable features of the emulator. The Canary version has some extra features that may or may not improve a game. It is an experimental build of it. Some games do benefit from it if you can configure it right, but for starters, you want to go and grab the master build for the most stable experience across most games. So go ahead and click on master to download it. It will come as a zipped file, so you're going to have to extract from it, and you can use either WinRAR or 7-zip, and I would personally recommend using 7-zip here. It just seems to have the best stability out there now. Once you have that installed, you're gonna click on it with the right button, put your mouse here on 7-zip, and then you're gonna click here on extract here. We can go ahead and delete the original zip file. We're not gonna need that anymore. Now, before you run Xenia, we're gonna do a little trick here to enable the emulator settings. So here on the same folder, you're gonna click on it with the right button, then select here, new, then click on folder. And you are now going to rename this folder's name to horrible.txt. Now press enter like this, and you can start Xenia. Double click here on xenia.ex. And by doing that, we have created the configuration document for Xenia. And this is what we're gonna be messing with here. So go ahead and close the emulator. You should be able to just double click on it and it will open. But if it's not, click on it with the right button. And then you're gonna click here on open with, and then you're gonna select notepad here. But if it's not showing up, you're gonna click here on more apps and you're gonna find the notepad. So moving on, let's open the configuration files by just double clicking on it. And here we have the settings for the emulator. Xenia does not have a user interface, so this is what we're going to be using here to modify the configuration from it. And there's a bunch of settings here, most of which you don't have to change anything to make the emulator run properly, but there's a few settings here that I like to go through. Scrolling down here a bit more, we have arrived at the draw resolution scale settings. This is the configuration of Xenia to render games at a higher resolution. By default, this emulator runs games at 720p resolution, and we can change that in here. The number 1 is 720p resolution, the number 2 is 1440p, the number 3 is 4K resolution, and so on. I'm not sure how far this emulator can go, but you probably don't need to go over 4K resolution, which is number 3. That is if your computer can handle that. So if you are going to increase the internal resolution, make sure that both numbers are even here. Otherwise, it's going to look broken in-game. And also, some games don't work well if they have their resolution increased, but this is something that can change as the emulator evolves. In my case, I'm just going to set mine at the default 720p resolution, so I'm not going to be changing anything here. Just before the general section here, we have the VSync option, which on the emulator, this is how you increase the frame rate of your games. By default, it's set to true, so the games will run at their original frame rate. And if you want to unlock that, you're going to replace the true with false. Now, the thing about VSync on Xenia is that when this option is set to false, The emulator will match the frame rate of the game to the same as the refresh rate of your monitor. So if you have a 60Hz monitor, the emulator will run the games at 60fps, which in most cases is a fine thing to happen. The games will run at that frame rate with no trouble. But if you have a 144Hz monitor or even higher than that, the emulator will run in that same frame rate. And in most cases on Xenia, this is a problem. Many games were not designed to run at that frame rate. So it will break the game by either making it run faster than what it should or breaking the physics. If that is your case, there is something that we can do to lock the frame rate at 60 here. If you have a NVIDIA graphics card, we're gonna head over to the control panel that you can normally find here on the taskbar of Windows. You're gonna click here on the little arrow. You're gonna see the icon of NVIDIA settings. Click on it with the right button and then click here on NVIDIA control panel. AMD graphics cards have the same feature, but since I don't have one, I don't know my way around their software. Either way, go ahead and click here on NVIDIA control panel. First off, click here on Manage 3D Settings, and then here on these two tabs, you select Program Settings. And if you're lucky enough, by clicking here on Select a Program to Customize, you're gonna see Xenia here on the top. So if it does show up here for you in this section, go ahead and click on it. But if it doesn't show up, you're gonna click here on Add and select Xenia here from this menu. But if it still doesn't show up, you're gonna click here on Browse. And from Windows Explorer, you're going to navigate to the folder where the emulator is. In my case, it's right here on this folder on the desktop. So you're gonna double click on Xenia.ex, and like that, it will finally show up in here. On this little window box, you're gonna scroll down here a bit and look for an option that says max frame rate. This one right here. So you're gonna click here on use global setting. To bring this drop down menu, you're gonna click right here on on, and then you're gonna select the maximum frame rate that you want the emulator to run at. In our case, it's 60 FPS. So you can click here on this little bar and use arrows on the keyboard to be more precise. Lock this one at 60. Now click here on OK and make sure you click here on the bottom where it says apply to save the settings. You can close this window now and go back to the settings document. Scrolling down on the list, we now have a section here to change the key binds of your controller. You don't have to change anything here unless you know what you're doing, because Xenia supports Xbox controllers by default. You just have to plug it in and play, whether it's a 360 or later controls. If you're using a PlayStation controller or a third-party controller, it can still be used on Xenia if you can make Windows recognize it as a Xbox controller. For example, there is a program called DS4 Windows that does that for PS4 controllers, and it works really well. I have personally used it for many years. There's also one for DualSense controllers as well. So as long as you can make them being recognized as Xbox controllers on PC, it will work on Xenia. The same applies for keyboards. Further down here, there's a section to change the language of the emulator. By default, Xenia runs in English, so if you want to change that, you just have to select the corresponding number here of the language you want and replace it here on user country or here on user language ID. So if you are going to play a game in a different language than English, this is the setting that you have to change here. That's all there's to it, to these settings. When you change everything you want, make sure you save this. By the way, click here on File, then click here on Save. You can safely close this now. Back on the emulator folder, you can go ahead and drop the games that you want to play here on the emulator. It will work just as fine. Or you can create a new folder here, all games, and place your games in there as well, just to make things more organized. But go ahead and double click on Xenia.ex, and to start your games, you're gonna click here on File and then select Open. Navigate to the folder where your games are and just double click on them. and just like that, the emulator will start them. To enable the post-processing effects on the emulator, you're gonna click here on Display, then click on Post-Processing Settings. This little window will show up and you can change these settings as the game is running, which is ideal to see the changes happening in real time. For the anti-aliasing, I think the normal quality looks good enough, but you can go all the way to extreme if you really want that, but in my case, normal quality is good. For the resampling and sharpening, using Super Resolution is what makes a lot of difference here. You can see that when I select that, the image instantly becomes more sharper and more clear, and you can also use this slider here to make even sharp or less if that's what you want to do here. And the great thing about it is that it can achieve this image fidelity without using a lot of your PC resources. So the performance cost for using this is very minimal. Now, installing DLC on Xenia is actually very straightforward. Back here on the emulator root folder, there's another folder called content that was already created by the emulator itself. And inside, you're gonna see the ID of the game that you run on the emulator before. So for installing the DLC, you must have played the game at least once here on the emulator. In this case, Gears of War, this is the same ID right here, the same one that shows in here. And inside this folder, this is where you're gonna be placing the actual DLC. I already have the DLC of Gears of War, so you're gonna have a folder with the ID of the game, and inside, this is the folder that you wanna move over to the content folder of Xenia, like this. So next time you run the game, you should already have the DLC installed. That's it for this tutorial. If you like what you saw, I have many videos like this on the channel, so make sure you check that out. Subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. And as always, I'll see you soon.